Try to stay professional up here. We try so hard. I think the banana Gil had in his trousers on that tilt. We try to keep it between the unitards and the bananas and the bang bang something in the.
We're very, all of us think we're all guilty.
I think we found the weak link to change. I just think there's a lot of fuckers up there. We do try to get professional every now and then, sometimes emotions
get the best of us,
right? I mean, we're all humans, every one of us, and even he has an emotional problem with his ex-lady. To turn down even robots can feel love and be inappropriate.
Yeah.
You're about to witness the awkward interaction that always is robot mind and our next guest.
She's a black Christian.
Okay, first question, Ruth. When did you make that shirt?
Actually, somebody just gave it to me.
Oh!
It's awesome.
That's awesome. Somebody made a robot.
It's a real thing, man. It's a real thing.
It's no longer a ghost.
When he doesn't see it yet because he's a robot. He's not reading it. And you're pointing to the book, and he sees it, and he goes, we all just wait for him to mess up the bass part.
It's wonderful to see the love between a robot and a wee bit of scotch blossom.
5'2" of scotch.
Damn right, boy. Bob, let's get Gil out of here. Let's get Ruthie to a bank next outfit. Go pretending to do a unitard to see what happens. I'm getting the hell off the stage. Here's the couple, everybody.
Temperature, you know what I mean? That bullshit. It's called asking for a pink pony. and I literally asked for a pink warrior. I don't know what the chances of that are happening. So anyway, so that pony was called, the first one was called Petunia, and I took Petunia back to Scotland for my niece, who ignored it, and her older brother took it and loved it. whatever makes you happy. And so then my next commission, I was out in Canada, somebody else brought me in my little pony, and I called her Lily Moon. And I'm trying to think of a name for this one. Rhea, where are you? Hi! Yeah, it's you. And I was thinking, Robina. I'll tell Robin it was fine. It'll be a whole thing, it'll be a whole bit, you'll love it. You all know he doesn't know. He doesn't know he has a My Little Pony called it. Just what he's always wanted. Anyway, so, in my suitcase that I like to carry around with me so that I get a sore neck all the time, I have some tail giveaways. Who doesn't know? That's my dry shampoo. Who doesn't know about the hotel giveaway section? You all know, okay. So, just to recap, oh, well, it's so good. The first creation convention I did was my band call. Good sake. And Erica Carroll turned up for her panel. Hi, glad you decided to join me. I had something better to do. Fine, I see how this is going. So Erica turned up with beautiful handmade cupcakes, and I turned up with me, with no cupcakes. So that night when I went home to the hotel, the cart was outside, you know, the room service, you know, the replenishing the room, so I stole things. And in that tradition, I continue to take things from hotels. And I spoil people who are brave enough to ask questions. I spoil them with things like lotion. I also have with me my Hope Chest wristbands. All books. I would appreciate it if everyone grabbed their boobs at some point the next minute. Okay, go. Men especially, I can see you, sir. Come on, I know you want to. Not ours, yours. Because the charity I support. So what I also have are V Club pins, which you're all going to do the V Club dance with me later so you can get inaugurated into the megaphone, whether you like it or not. And so these pins, I love the design of them. I bought them, I paid for them, and so when you make a donation, if you go to the My Hope Chest website and make a $10 donation, that's a suggested amount, you bring me your phone and show me the receipt, I give you one of these, and so therefore 100% of the money goes to charity. Right? So yeah, I'll have them with me in the vendors. Got half an hour later to the day tomorrow. So if you want to do that, my Hope Chest will be really happy. That being said, introduction more. Who's going to ask me a question first? Is it this side or this side? And you. What's your name?
I'm Susan.
Where are you from?
Here.
What do you want?
I was wondering, who's your celebrity crush?
God, I have so many.
Person that comes to mind?
I'm blanking on her name. Oh my God. I love her so much. She watched Billions. Maggie Smith. I have questions on amazing actors. She's fucking amazing. I have a crush, major crush on Michael Fassbender. I have a crush on this, you might not have heard of him, but there's a guy called Jensen Ackles. Bye!
I've never seen such a moving audience before.
I'm going to keep talking about my crushes. I'm really liking Billy Crudup in Gypsy. Just now, the whole program's freaking me out though. Have you seen it? Oh man, it's so tense. So tense. I can't watch it later now, I just can't sleep. It's so tense. Who else? I have a crush on... I met Peter Capaldi recently, twice. He's a brilliant actor. I met David Tennant. I have to tell you the story. It's not really got a punchline. Keep telling it. I met him at a party a few years ago, and I was so keen not to be a fangirl. Apparently, I was borderline rude, standoffish. He was like, "Yeah, he just want to play at the same theatre I'm gonna play at," and I was like, "Yeah, hi." So I saw him last week, and I was like, "Hi, David. I met you at a Christmas party a long time ago, a few years ago." I said. You just look back in anger at the Lyceum. And he was like, "Ruth, that was 11 years ago." That's when I realised I was really old. I have a crush on... There's a tall chap called Jordan Padaluki. I just see Rob in a dip suit over there. Speak's not bad either. Who else? This is a really good, I could do this question for the whole panel. My first celebrity crush, I think, was Flash Gordon. I wanted to be tied up in an orange bikini and rescued, and that hasn't changed. Should I finish this question? That's my impression of the whole panel. Who else? I love, I posted this thing last year, it made me laugh. Wasn't my jokes. My ideal weight is Chris Pratt on top of me. Who else is there? Who's alive? Who else is alive in the world today that I don't have a crush on? Who? I love you too. Hi, sir. Hi.
Hello.
Nice to see all your faces. Oh, there, I'm just blinded by the light. You're late. Where are you?
I had Alicia up.
Okay. Hi. Hi. It's her first time.
Like you should be one step ahead of yourself.
I'm never gonna get to you. I'm never gonna get to you. This is how long I take to do anything. I really do. So I'll come and say hi because I'm not gonna get to you. Just letting you know that. So I'll come and embarrass you now.
Hi.
I'm sorry I'll not get to your question. Maybe yours, because you're ginger. Hi.
I'll get to your question. I'm pretty sure you'll get to yours.
Hi. How are you?
Good, thank you.
I'll get to you, Molly. Is it yours at this side? This is question number two, 45 minutes in. Sebastian Roche, eat your heart out. What's your name?
Where are you from? What do you want?
Jordan, and I'm from around here.
Around these parts?
Yes. My question for you is, were you disappointed that your death wasn't on screen?
I was... Do you know what? I was a bit worse than that. Mouth washing my mouth out of death in that question. If I could copy that laugh, I would use that laugh. Who did it? I'm coming over there in a minute.
I always thought you would go down fighting.
I was going to make a really rude joke about it. Nevertheless, I stayed up to live tweet the finale because I wanted to join in and be part of it. And I honestly, it wasn't rational. Because I read the script and everything, been warned about it, told about it, but to watch it at 3:30 in the morning, and I honestly felt so discombobulated because it was done so offhand. And so casually brutal. And I actually think that it's had the desired impact in the right way because it was so rude. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
The response was that wasn't good enough for Arena, and also we don't believe it. It wasn't good enough. You know, I feel like it got the right amount of anger. And a lot of response from people who don't normally say stuff. So I actually think it did its job. And the truth is, and this is me reading because I do this, I read stuff into things that are not there all the time. But really, that's what happened to a lot of women. There was almost a genocide of women over the centuries for witchcraft, for being paid, you know, for working with herbs and helping people, you know, burned to a crisp or drowned, tested to be a witch by being drowned, then you're dead, but you're not a witch. Great. I have a spin-off idea about that. So I feel a lot of things about it. Disappointment's not one. That's not the word, but a lot of other feelings. Yeah? Makes sense? Yeah? Thank you for your question.
Thank you. Thank you.
Somebody said to me recently, who was it said to me? In Supernatural, where there's death, there's hope. It's the only show where that applies. More chance. Do more episodes if you're actually dead. It's weird. But yeah, we'll have to wait and see. So are you all? And this is the closest I get to Kelly Reno. He actually was just, we message each other on Twitter. We DM each other. Is that the same kind of message? I love my heart. And even though he killed me, I love him.
Hi, Ruth. I'm saying welcome back to Chicago.
I was staying here last year. I love coming to Chicago. I've been to Chicago like 5 or 6 times. And on Thursday night, I booked dinner. Because I'm like so in the north. I have my favorite restaurants in Chicago. I love it, so thank you for having me back.
For sure. And my question is, well, first off, I'm a really short person for a guy. And I'm only like 5'4". And all of my friends are like 6 feet tall and whatnot. And jokingly, I get teased for it because I don't look like my age either. People always mistake me to be like 15 years old. And I know Mark Shepard would always tease you on set because you are a short person.
Because I was the only person smaller than him.
And I was just curious, how did that work on a daily basis? And this is really advice for me. How I can kind of just.
Mark Shepard on a daily basis. I love him so much. And sorry, first of all, I didn't notice you were short.
Oh, I am actually short.
But I didn't, didn't occur to me. I don't think of myself as short, and then I see photographs. So it was my friend's wedding, and there was a whole bunch of girls who would all work together, and the picture is like, person,
Ruth,
person. I'm not small, am I? I think I never remember. And then so Mark would continually point it out, and on a nice day, on a good day, he would call me Wee Bit, which I really like. And then other days he would call me not nice names, and I would ignore him.
I'd always get called a small fry, so I'm in the same boat as you.
Tootsie, that's okay, that's kind of a cute way. I think it's easier for girls, right? It's easier for girls to be shorter. But all the best things come in small packages, so.
Exactly. Thank you.
Silks on them.
Oh.
I never leave the house without a wedge. Hi. How are you?
I absolutely love your chapter in Family Donut with Blood.
Oh, thank you.
So touching. I was wondering if you would write more in the future because your style of writing was great.
Oh, thank you. I am. When Lynn asked, is Lynn here? When she first asked me to do it, I was like, I haven't written an essay since I was in high school. And then I did it begrudgingly. So I wrote a chapter that was so, so serious. It made your eyes bleed reading it. So that was my second attempt. And I really had to have a word with myself about just doing it. I'm going to give you this actually. I'm going to give you this. You're one of my main Twitter followers. So this is a badge somebody gave me in Germany. I'm giving you this as well. What was I saying? I was waffling on about.
Oh.
Yeah. So I had to go work on myself and just finish it. But completion, not perfection. Really? Otherwise I would never ever have done it. And I thought, just do it, finish it, move on with your life. Everything will be okay. And then it's been so nice because it's actually come back in a really positive way, which I wasn't looking for or expecting. So thank you. And my mum ordered it and I was like, Mum, I've got a copy for you here. So she ordered it and had it posted to Scotland. And have many of you got the book? I was sent a couple of chapters because I was nervous about doing it. I said to Lynn, can I see a couple of example chapters? So I did read a couple of other ones first. And I thought they were really, really good. So yeah, I would like to write. I've always wanted to write a book. I really want to write, create a show or a film. Or so I really want to do that. Not this year, but I would like to, so thank you. And so yeah, here's your body lotion. White tea aloe, don't say I'm not good to you. Your wristband. Thank you, thank you. I'm glad you could join us. Who are you? Just now. Misha. It's hard to match ever. Go to a prize for Misha too. Or wings or something. Hi.
Hi. Alright, oh, are you looking at my shirt?
You've got Mark Sheffield all over your hand. In America you call that a fan. I'd say nothing else.
How are you?
Good.
Alright.
What's your name?
I'm Stephanie. Yeah.
Where are you from?
I'm from Chicago.
What do you want?
So, if Rowena was still alive, what do you think she would be up to?
Plotting revenge. I think it would give her a real big purpose. I think it was interesting in season 12 that it started with Rowena just wanting the quiet life. Well, quiet for her, you know, gambling, stealing, you know. Killing people, but you know, she just wanted to drink martinis with a Republican in a tennis club. You know, she, just the end of the world, near the end of the world, all been a bit too much, and whatnot. And so, without trying to take over the Grand Coven or create a Mega Coven or you know, work with the darkness or stop the end of the world like that, what's her purpose now? So I actually think that Rowena could now have. Like in acting terms, super objectively, is the main thing. But like in life, the biggest purpose ever. Because hell had no fury like a woman scorned twice. That's the bare minimum that would be happening. And then it would be massages with handsome young men, pink champagne, diamonds, and rubies. And Godiva chocolate. Probably, and holidays to Bora Bora. Bora Bora. Tell Mike. Thank you. Are you all doing this still awake? Am I going to have to get you up on your feet? Do the deep club megabits? Yeah? Okay, that's going to happen now. Get up. Get up.
You like a lot.
Alright, so whether you like it or not, without your permission, I'm going to film it and post it to my Facebook page. There's only about 100,000 people who'll see it. So don't feel self-conscious. Oh, I've got a message from Alina Huffman and from Brianna Buckmaster. I don't like to ignore texts.
Aww.
Alina, I want to give you money for the cake.
Ruthie, I love my gifts.
Oh. Okay, sorry. Okay, so I've got Facebook. The live video is ready, because we're going to do this fast. You guys, I know you guys from Chicago, you're just like on it. I'm going to pick this up so quick, right? So after three, I go 1, 2, 3, then you go and you say it. You go, V Club. That's not me, that's a palm tree. Mega, you need dogs doing it. Mega. And this is the bit you're all rubbish at, it makes me laugh, so I'll keep it in. Disco ball change, disco ball change. Okay, go through it. Okay, go. Disco ball change, disco ball change. See it? Disco ball change. Hell yeah! much as we charge them. After three, one, two, three.
We want America. Disco ball change. Disco ball change. Hell yeah.
Okay, but you need to shake your boobs, men especially, a lot more. No, S-E-N-G, so you can all see yourselves. I'm going to call it S-E-N-G Trouble Shuffle. Are you ready? Okay, I'm going live.
Good day.
Queen Ruth of Chicago here. I'm crying in my bejewels.
Yeah,
actually since I started watching Alan Taylor.
Your friends with
Lottie.
Yeah.
And I don't want to mispronounce her last name, so I'm just going to say Lottie. Okay. So, your character, Rowena, was a witch in the 1700s. She time travels an Outlander back to the 1700s.
Sorry.
And is perceived as a witch.
Mm-hmm. Is that it?
If she time traveled to Supernatural, would you allow her in your mega vita?
I would let her in to see what spells I could steal from her. It's so funny because Lottie, I admired her. She was in the Borgias. I saw her in a movie with Stephen Ray before I ever met her. And then one of my good friends, Sarah, was at the actor's studio with her. And I was like, I love her. She's a lovely actress. And we were at my friend's a screening of a movie, and Lottie was there. And I was like, hi! I said, I really love your work. I'm not a weirdo. Like, I fangirl on her. I'm an actress, God. I'm in a show. And she was really cool. And she actually messaged me. She reached out to me on Facebook, and so we started messaging each other. So one red-haired Scottish witch to another. So she was filming Outlander, and I'm filming Supernatural. And it's really funny, right? How life comes around. She's one of my besties now. She's great. And I just was in Amsterdam with her in a year. She's amazing. Amazing actress, and she's really going places. She did a movie with Vin Diesel, you know, she's so we might not be able to afford her. Is the only problem. But yeah, that's life's funny, isn't it?
And then you said it, you were friends with her and talked about the blonde wig thing, and then you got the blonde wig, so I thought maybe you could talk about
absolutely.
Coming over.
Yes, she'll
okay.
Heart and Michael Fassbender.
Yeah.
There you go.
Michael Fassbender. Oh my God.
Sam? You can't not say Sam
Healy. Who?
Sam Healy.
Sam Healy. I remember Sam. He used to work at one of the theaters I would perform in. And I was at an event, and I saw him, and I thought, just go and speak to him. He's a Scottish actor, and lots of people that know him. And I started walking towards him, and he was with a guy, a couple of guy pals, and they were like, here's a girl coming to chat you up. And at which point, my brain melted, and I felt so embarrassed. And I turned into a game and said, since now, I think it's a bit like this. He's super nice, he's a super nice guy. He's so handsome. He's disgusting. It's a bit like Jens, he's a bit like looking into the sun. And then he's freckled. So freckled in his eyes as well.
This
is a lot of information. This is what's speckled in his green eyes.
You're gorgeous, oh my God. So in the beginning of your panel, you were talking about how you like stealing stuff from hotel rooms and whatnot. So I was wondering, what's your favorite thing you've stolen in the past? Or...
Oh gosh. Why do you want to come after me to get it back? I think the favorite thing I've ever stolen is your heart. Get away with that one. The cheesiest answer of the day. Thank you. Thank you. Hi.
Hello. So everybody here knows that Rowena was the most powerful witch that ever existed. So I want to know, how did Rowena actually avoid dying?
When?
Because you can't be dead, you're too powerful. You know how to avoid. I mean, probably could avoid dying than you know Rowena.
I spoke to one of the writers about this from the very, very, very beginning, that Rowena's a cat with 9 lives, but she can't remember if she's on 7 or 8. Do you know what I mean? Because she's not...
She's flawed. She's not a nymphomaniac. Super. You know what I mean? She ducks and dives and dodges and weaves. Yeah, she's always taking one step ahead, but she's just surviving. She's like back in the scavenger cap. Do you know what I mean? She's in hard times. And do you see how I'm avoiding the question?
But
what are you talking about? Let's just stay in the lounge, right? What happens in the room stays in the room. Oh! Speak of the God.
Yeah.